When we were growing up, we were just a bunch of mates hanging out and playing and training and just doing it because we loved it and because it was fun, basically. We all came from that youth circus background, and particularly at Circus, back in our generation, there was a really heavy emphasis on group work. When we went to the Tassie Circus Festival, we learned Toss the Girl with Das and Dave and Chels. And so we did a lot of that group stuff, all group, not very much individual stuff at all.
So GOM started in 2009, and it was kind of at the tail end of our kind of time together at Circus. So most of us had been in the troupe together for about 10 years, and we were all kind of graduating from the troupe.
The troupe.
Yeah, the troupe. We call it
the troupe. The troupe.
And you train two or three times a week, and you do little corporate gigs every now and then, and you kind of get exposure to performance and the real kind of performance artistic world. It's a little more intense, I guess.
And we decided we wanted to keep working together and make a show. We didn't really have any idea about where we wanted to take it. It was just that we wanted to keep training, and making a show was a good reason to do that. So yeah, we premiered Freefall, our first show, later that year in Melbourne, and then it kind of all just rolled on from there. So we kept doing Freefall for 3 years, and then did a Simple Space. Well, started a Simple Space in 2013.
Literally the Tassie Circus Fest in 2013, and that was, we had a whole bunch of material but didn't have a kind of framework or a context for it, and then a couple of days before we were presenting on main stage, we kind of found this concept of game which had kind of played out through some bits, but then found that and everything just like fell into place. So it was just like that became the context for a Simple Space, and then we were able to build on and grow, but like that was kind of fluky. That was like someone getting naked as we were about to do something else and turning it into a game, and strip skipping was the start of what a Simple Space was, really. Like we had all the material but had no way to frame it. We were like rehearsing going, this is shit, this is terrible. And then we came across that and it felt so right, because gameplay is how we've created all of our stuff. And we're like, that's ridiculously simple, but it totally worked for us. Yeah, Tassie Circus Festival was like kind of fluke, kind of scenario, situation, luckiness. Yeah, that's how good things come up sometimes, hey? It's like you do all the work and then the door opens. It's like, oh. That was like one of the most like explosive moments of our kind of, you know, it's all industry. It's like all your friends, all the people you've grown up with, all the people that you've got respect for who have kind of paved the path. And then to do that there and to come up with something kind of that was feeling right in the moment. And a lot of the skills and a lot of things we'd learnt were from, you know, circus festivals past before that and from people that were around there. So to be able to peel that all together and land that, yeah, on that stage, that was amazing. Like I get goosebumps like looking at that footage again. I've looked at it more recently, but yeah, it's something else. Even though the show itself, I'm looking at it going, oh, that's terrible. Like we've since, you know, rewritten the whole thing, but that energy that came from it, I think was enough to make us go, oh, someone likes it, it's fun, it's good, yeah.
We're doing well. Like, Freefall is like nothing in it.
Lovely, lovely. Yeah. Yeah, she did it?
We did a week of showings here in Adelaide Fringe, and then everyone was traveling. We were kind of thinking, Gone was being put to bed at that stage. We'd done a free fall tour around Australia, and we're like, beautiful, did the touring thing.
And that was gonna be like the last thing we were gonna do.
Last hurrah.
Last hurrah, like we're done, we're gonna go do our normal lives, study engineering, do graphic design or whatever.
We met someone on that tour who
it was in,
had like a, yeah, in a town of...
A tiny little town on
Moora,
the west coast.
I think rings a bell, but it had like, we had eight people come to the show or something, and someone who saw it was like, yeah, one of my family members, sister or auntie or something, yeah, worked in Edinburgh Fringe.
There was a connection at Edinburgh, at one of the venues.
And was like, yeah, you guys should go along.
So we didn't have much cell phone reception or anything like that, so we were... calling people from Edinburgh and doing this just one night on an Australian tour. And
yeah, because it was like 2 days before registration closed.
Yeah, it was real quick. So we decided to go over to Edinburgh with A Simple Space, the new show that we'd just made.
We can go to Edinburgh and kind of pretend that we've done some overseas touring thing and see what it's all about, and that was it, and everyone had their university they're going back to and all these other things. It was like that was definitely the end of it. And then just worked our tits off there and had a great little show that people were like really digging, and so it started selling out there. And then we got in touch with a bunch of different people, but Wolfgang Hoffman, who's now our agent, he picked us up there, and we got a really great connection with him. And then
we kind of had a couple of weeks to decide if we wanted to stop working together or if we wanted to actually take it to the next level and work full time. The complete opposite.
Me and Marty were pretty annoyed. We had a 6 month Euro trip plan. We took the year off uni and did everything. And these guys were like, come back and, you know, like make this show with us. And we were like, nah, like we're just on holiday. We've done the circus. Like we've kind of done this thing. And then we came back and realised that we had a serious opportunity here.
Yeah, that's right.
That's kind of when it switched for me in my head. I went, what am I doing on holiday when I can be travelling, working, seeing the world from a totally different, unique perspective? Yeah.
Pretty much from 2014, started 2014, you know, it started with probably slabs of like 4 months worth of touring, plus a couple of months. And, you know, 2015 was like probably 9-10 months of the year. 2016 was probably like 10 or 11 months of the year. And, you know, the shows toured, I think Simple Space has performed maybe 300 plus times across 30 plus countries. It's like, you know, from putting it to bed to suddenly it exploding and going, actually, that was just the beginning. That was pretty unreal, hey. But yeah, and it continues, like it's booked through to 2018 and beyond, even now. Yeah, it's crazy.
Yeah. I'm not anymore. I've dropped out. That's in the past. I was doing graphic design for a year, but I wasn't going to do that anyway.
Right. Yeah, I'm like two out of 5 years in an aerospace engineering degree.
We'll see.
Don't think that's coming back.
We'll see whether it all happens. This is what we're doing at the moment. Yeah. And it's bloody good fun.
Yeah, lots of fun. Five, four, three, two. One.